Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a triple threat. He's a rapper, a stand-up comedian, and an actor who always makes us laugh, especially in movies like Roll Bounce and Tropic Thunder. Please welcome the always funny Brandon T. Jackson.
Yes. What's good?
Hello.
How you doing?
Hello. How are you? Good to see you as well, sir.
How are you?
Have a seat here.
How are you?
Purple.
Yes.
Look at you looking good.
Kingship. Trying to.
You got it all going on.
Trying to get my grown man on.
Yes. I mean, you came away from around the corner with so much swag.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Wakanda swag.
Yes.
I love it.
My God.
No, this is Northeast African.
Yes. I love it.
It's Israel. So, yeah.
Yes. So, is this your design?
It's my design, yes. Kingdom clothing. I just got sick of buying other people's stuff. Mm-hmm. I believe in ownership. You know what I mean? We got to have ownership of our stuff. So, I'm trying to do my thing.
You're all right. You look
good
over there.
Thank you.
I love it.
Being ATL.
Yeah.
Tyler Perry paying off stuff.
Right.
Pay off my child support.
No, stop.
Oh, my God. Well, listen, speaking of child support, you were number 5 of 7
yes.
siblings.
Wow. Wow.
Yes. Grew up a preacher's kid out mm-hmm. of Detroit, Michigan.
Yes.
My God, what was it like growing up in the church?
I love it. Beautiful. I'm still, that's why, you know, for me, I always keep it with me at this point of my career. I got a new production company. I'm actually moving here.
Oh, good.
Kingdom of Everything Productions, doing more inspirational stuff.
Really?
Yeah, I'm changing. I got kids now.
Yeah. You're going to be on the
You made an R at first, but as soon as you get those kids, you be like, I'm family man. So, yeah, but it's cool though. It's beautiful. It's an evolution of who I am. 27 generations of you know, Levitical priests. I gotta stay with it. So that's who I am.
Yeah,
you know?
That's all right, baby.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. Yeah.
Anointing. I can feel. I
you
can feel the child support getting paid off.
All right, baby.
So wait, Hanukkah? Yeah, are you celebrating? You celebrate?
Well, I'm an Israelite. Yeah, definitely.
Oh.
Yeah, of course.
We went down to your Instagram and we saw that you celebrate Hanukkah.
Right. No, what a feast of dedication. That's what that is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah. But I'm Messianic. I believe in Christ, of course.
Definitely. Right. Yeah. So what's it? Can you break it down? In layman's terms for people who don't know? Because I was.
Well, you gotta understand. The Ashanti, and the Yoruba, and the Igbo tribes were Israelites. Those were the main tribes that were brought to America. You know, I was talking to one of my rabbis. He was like, yeah, the Hebrews are black,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yeah,
so,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. you know, and it's, they got that new movie coming out with, you know, Christ being, with a black Christ, which mm-hmm. is great because that's, you know, back to the original form, but it's nothing wrong, you know, we love everybody,
yeah.
but I just know who we are, and yeah. I just walk with it, and,
yeah.
you know, I just, you know, I'm chilling, this is happy feast of dedication, we chilling, you
know what I'm saying?
Yes, now, as a stand-up comic, like, do you go back to your roots as
always.
Far as being, yeah, a peak for material?
Hood, suburbs. I'm from both, so yeah. I'm from the hood and the suburbs.
Yeah.
So I mean, yeah, that's me with no hair.
Yeah.
Now I look like Ludacris a little bit.
I look at you.
But yeah, you know, it's just different. Like for me, I like to talk about like my being a fish out of water.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if you've ever been the only black person in the suburbs.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You know, they talk about slavery. Everybody look at you. They be in the history class and everything. Like, so just being a fish out of water,
right. yeah.
talking about things that and political stuff that you know, I just believe in. And I try to help us laugh at our differences because we need some light right now.
Yeah, we do.
It's too dark.
You don't know what to say.
Yeah.
It's you know.
I know.
Well, now listen. We recently talked about Kevin Hart when we opened our show. You know,
deep.
We get deep, boots.
We're trying to sell some tickets.
We're gonna sell tickets right after we comment on this.
So listen. We talked a little bit about Kevin Hart. We understand that he didn't want to apologize for things that may have transpired many years ago, mm-hmm. 2009, 2010, 11, whatever. He apologized for it then, and then they said, "Well, if you don't apologize, then you can't host the Oscars."
Yeah.
What is your stance on that?
Well, I believe in standing what you believe. Mm-hmm. You know, Kaepernick, he can't even get back in the NFL. You
right.
know, for belief, standing what you believe in. Everybody has a right for sovereign will to stand at what they believe in.
Yeah.
It might not. Here's what people are saying. People are different. You
yes.
know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
You might not have the same beliefs as somebody. Isn't that what America was built on? So you can't. Expect somebody to, you know, to bow to someone else's mm-hmm. beliefs because mm-hmm. everyone has some their own beliefs
yeah.
as it pertains to,
mm-hmm.
and that's the freedom of America.
Yeah.
So for me, Kevin has the right for his opinion, and every community has a right to their to to their standpoint.
But he's already apologized. Don't you think that if a person has apologized for it once, how much do they actually have to apologize before it actually sinks in?
Well, you know, it's like this, you know, it's one of those things where Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, they didn't bow to a certain thing because that was a way of showing themselves as being, I should say,
solidarity.
Solidarity. Yeah. Sometimes you got to just stand up for what you believe in.
Right. Well, you're standing up this weekend.
Yes, Atlanta Comedy.
Yes. Like that, Carl.
You see how it runs good. Yeah, thanks, sis. So you're standing up at the Atlanta Comedy Theater.
We getting deep. Y'all done got me going deep.
That's fine.
Got me on here like, see, sister, what we trying to do. Stop.
Tell me a little bit about your show this weekend. What can your audience expect? And you know, you're in Atlanta, so is that tough for you?
Nah, for what?
Last question.
I'm in Zion. We having a great time. This is my people. And the thing is this, your people too, you know, we out here. So I like having fun, man. I really, you know, I just, you got to challenge people's thoughts, you know what I mean? But Atlanta's always, I'm shooting my special here too.
Yes. Come on, man.
So I'm going to shoot my special in ATL. So love you. I love Atlanta. I've always sell out here. We always do it. And God bless, we're about to go to the gym.
That's right. Brandon B. Jackson, if you are in the Atlanta area this weekend, you can catch him at the Atlanta Comedy Theater. And the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms. The amazingly talented Brandon B. Jackson. Yeah. Everybody, yes! Break it down. Yes. You better.
You better.